Hello, everybody. My name is Ed. I'm in my armchair, and the smoking lamp is lit. And guess what? I'm smoking the second oldest of my favorite pipes. And I'm smoking dark, strong Kentucky. Why? We'll get to that a little later. But this is the pipe. This is the first pipe I ever bought. Bought this in Hong Kong. And I'm also smoking this simply because this also is a little bit answering a question about what shape I like the best. Got a lot of little stuff to cover, little questions to be covered. But first, I'm going to put this down and talk about something that happened to me on International Pipe Smoking Day. Because this is important. And of course, there's a story. Look at this guy. Is that beauteous or what? This is a Vauen, our land pipe for Lord of the Rings. Vauen got the official approval to make the Lord of the Rings pipes. This is one of them. Beautiful wood. So, first, how I even learn about two things, the pipe itself and International Pipe Smoking Day. This was before I even was too familiar with even YouTube, with the, you know, pipe community. I was watching Mutton Chop Piper, and he has a ritual where he has a pipe of this nature. His is a little bit better, or actually a little bit older. One of the first that Vauen did. This is one of the later ones. And what he has as a ritual is that he takes this pipe out only once a year on International Pipe Smoking Day. And he has some Penzance, and that's what he will smoke in it on that day. So that was the first I heard about International Pipe Smoking Day. And it was the first time I'd ever heard about these pipes. So I had to get one. Now, I don't just smoke this only on International Pipe Smoking Day, but it is a pipe that I will smoke every International Pipe Smoking Day. And this year, for the first time, I have some Penzance. And what I want to talk about is just that special smoke. Now, I'm not sure what happened. I got up as usual, had some coffee. It was a Sunday, so instead of a lunch, I usually love having a breakfast. And I had waffles with Vermont maple syrup that I bought in Vermont, butter, some breakfast sausages. One of these breakfasts I really love. And then, just a little while after that, that's when I got this pipe out, put some Penzance in there, and I've smoked a Penzance before, so it's not, again, a ritual, but for this time, my first time I had it, I was smoking out of this pipe. And it didn't take long to start smoking this and realizing that everything's is right in the world. I must have packed it exactly what needed. It must have been exact moisture content, the perfect pipe. My palate must have been just set up great for it. But I started smoking this pipe and I really had one of these special bowls. And I'll tell you, I don't have that many of them. Like, you know, I mean, when it just all pieces together. And again, this was the first time I've used this pipe with Penzance. Maybe that was the combination, but I think it was everything. And I just knew that this was going to be a special smoke. It just tasted something about it. It all came together on International Pipe Smoking Day. Now you got to believe I'm going to be having this a little bit more with the Penzance. But I wanted to just tell you about that because it doesn't happen that often. I mean, a lot of people on gauze have, you know, have you ever had this and stuff? And I've only had a few that were just pieced together. So, my pipe, and of course, it was my favorite pipe that day, or at that time. But I had to tell you about it because it just was, it was something special. Now I smoke maybe once out of every 3 to 4 weeks, I might not smoke anything. Other than that, I'm pretty much 3 to 4 bowls in the evening, late afternoon, evening. During football season, I will start smoking a little early. But yeah, I would say on the average, 3 to 4 bowls. And of course, different pipe, because that's what it's all about. Different tobaccos, each one. But still, those few smokes that just everything is right in the world. That just happened to me. Had to let you know. It was incredible. So I'm going to put this down and I'll get right back to you. So one thing also, when I smoke my Lord of the Rings Churchwarden, I use this tamper. Can you see it? Sorry, not that great of a camera. This is Jack the Piper. Giuliano. He does incredible work. This is his wizard tamper. He has London Tower or Big Ben. He has a lot of jewelry grade tampers, and also just jewelry grade jewelry. You got to check him out, Jack the Piper. I love this. It's beautiful. This definitely comes out with my tamper, or with my, you know, pipe. Okay. We're going to cover a few other things people have asked. TreeTop Piper. We got Brad the Bearded Piper. B-Dog Piper. He's having a gall just for the hell of it. B-Dog Piper. Just for the hell of it. So I really think that's incredible because it's a great gall. But just for the hell of it, why don't you subscribe to him and check him out? Just for the hell of it. You got to love that in a gall. Brad the Bearded Piper, he asked, oops. Oh my God. Oh yeah. He's having a gall giving away 6 Zippo lighters. I've also had comments on a video where I did my collection of figurines. And I asked them, do a little collection of lighters. So I'm going to do that. Now, this is not really a collection per se, but I got a lot. So I'm going to show some of them to you. You know what I mean? So here we go. Let me put this guy down again. Because we'll start with matches. Have a little thing for him. I got a bunch of little things to put matches in. 3-star safety matches. Can you believe it? I had to get advice for matches. I had other types, and they would have little flares and stuff. And it was mentioned about these, the 3-star. Love it. So yeah, a little advice. Don't have that a problem. I also have this guy here. Cedar stays. And when I'm in a good mood, especially kind of in the winter, a lot of doing the Churchwardens, I'll use these. You light those, then use that to light your pipe. The cedar stay. It's kind of a winter time thing for me. So anyway, let's go through some of the typical ones. I got Macanudo, because also I do smoke cigars and I got stuff from them. Of course, Bix. But I don't use these for lighting my pipe much, but I have them. I do have a few, you know, running out. You know, the stronger flame for cigars. You know? Good stuff. Yeah. Okay. Now we get into a little bit better Vic type, you know, because it aims down. I like that. I also have this little guy. This was a cigar guy too. Has a little cigar cutter. Gotta like it, you know? Okay. This guy, this is a Vauen lighter I got through eBay, but it's a little bit more like the old boy. I don't have anything in this right now. I've used it up and I haven't refilled it. But still, like that. Then I have a few like this. to aim down for pipes. I like that. I use those a lot. Where's my other ones? Oh, yeah. Stanwell, one in a gall. Love it. And of course, you recognize this a lot. People do this in the dim sum. Like it, like it. Okay. Oh, and yeah, the Forever Match, I think it's called. I don't have anything lit in this because I say take this if I'm actually going out as kind of that extra lighter. Okay, then we got, whoops. I'm all discombobulated here. Anyway, I got this guy. This is basically three of the same thing. This is what I use pretty much all the time because you can go down into the pipe for it. That is how I like to smoke the pipes or light them. Straight down, don't get hurt. Trouble with these is they're not shite. They don't light all the time. They don't seem to hold that much fuel. But these are what I love. And of course, these guys. For lighting a pipe. These were given to me by a friend when this one got the seals room, got another one. They don't really seem to make them anymore. So I got this guy. Doesn't hold that much fuel because of, you can see the size of it. But I love it for, you know, lighting up my pipes. So that's all of that, except for what the topic about this is Zippos. So yeah, I have regular Zippo, just a chrome, regular base Zippo. But these two, this one here is from 1970. And I don't know if you can tell. That's my ship, the Benjamin Stoddard DDG-22. On that, from 1970, when I happened to be in the Navy at the time. I also, when I was in the Navy, and I've lost it, I had a Zippo, a brushed chrome. I do not know what happened to that. I don't remember having it once I got out of the Navy, so probably left it up on the signal bridge. And then another chrome one. Again, this is my ship, or the insignias for my ship, and this one I got through eBay. So anyway, that's my lighters as we have them. Not that much of a collection, but they asked, and I, you know what I mean? So, a couple more questions answered. One was, do you have a favorite winter blend? Yes and no. All of my tobaccos, and especially Philosopher, which you say, you know, is my favorite all-time tobacco. I really don't, you know, have, I smoke anything at any time. But, this year, for the first time, early fall, I got some Northwoods. I loved it. Got some more, got a pound of it. Then I won some from Cane Rod Piper's Gaw. Got some from 2018. So this is the tobacco I have bought the most of lately and smoked more than their fair share of, considering all the other weird stuff I have. So I would say this would be my winter blend until about 2 weeks ago. And then another call, I got what I'm smoking now, the Orlik Dark Strong Kentucky. And this is the first time I've ever done a Kentucky. And this is from 2015. And unfortunately, I understand it's not made anymore. But if I were to have a winter blend, this would be it. And of course, you know, I have PAD and TAD. Now I got to expand TAD to what? Kentucky's. So I'm going to be getting a few more of the Kentucky, the dark Kentucky blends. So this would be my winter's blend. I love it. So finally, and this all pieces together again with this pipe, we had two questions. One, favorite style, if you will. And that is this. This, to my eye, this is the shape that appeals to me the most. And again, this is the second pipe, or the first pipe I ever bought, just from the looks. And since then, of course, I have all kinds of pipes, all kinds of shapes, for the most part, traditional shapes and close to it. And I would still say a good, you know, half bent pipe. I just love the looks of it, how it feels. Now, again, I don't clench, so anything can go. But it's right here. Smoke isn't in your face. That doesn't really bother me, but this would be it. And the final question from TreeTop Piper wanted to just give a little history of it, which kind of I have. This is the second first pipe I ever bought. This was the second pipe I had. First one was a gift, just a really basic billiard, meerschaum lined. That got me going and piping. And the question is, how or why did I get into piping? And I've mentioned this before. My dad smoked every day a cigar and later pipes. But I was raised with it. I mean, my dad would be smoking a pipe in his chair, and me and my sisters would be on the floor playing and stuff like that. I grew up with it. So taking up smoking was kind of just a natural thing. My grandfather had smoked a lot. He was definitely an old codger, Prince Albert. When he before, rather than cleaning out his pipe and reaming it, just get a new one, you know, at probably the local grocery store in Trenton. So that meant I was kind of inclined to it. Stayed away from cigarettes through high school, which I'm glad I didn't get hooked on the cigarettes. And in those days, the jocks, not that I was a jock, but I was in sport pretty much every year round. Soccer, basketball. Anyway. But when I joined the Navy, I got out of boot camp, was sent to signalman school in Hawaii, and that's where I met two guys who were in my class that smoked pipes. And it just kind of, I was going to be probably doing that anyway, but since they smoked pipes, I got my first gift from my, technically my brothers at, who are eight, you know, gave it to me, my first pipe, which I still smoke now. But having a pipe, being on a ship, is just something else. Now, I don't know what I don't know, didn't know, about packing the pipe. I just kind of did it. Didn't worry about tongue bite. At that time, mostly Orkham Riff as the tobacco. And it just, you're a sailor. You're about to see, you gotta have a pipe. So I had my pipes, eventually, you know, the other ones that I got, right on the signal bridge, where's a signalman? And I would smoke them on watch, you know, in the evening. And that's how I kind of came to pipe smoking. Had no questions about it. Slowly learned a little bit of this, a little bit of that stuff. And the rest is history. So, I hope you like this. Again, my Peterson. I've had obviously for 40, 50 two some years, still love it, smoking the strong, dark Kentucky in it, and chose this one because of all the little things, questions asked, and I tried to answer, and had some fun. So, a lot of people for you to check out, because they're having gauze or they're just asking questions. So, as always, hope you like this. So, hit like and subscribe so that I know who's out there. This is how I find out who to check out for their videos. And remember, if you don't like, you're not going to get to heaven. So may your smoking lamp always be lit. And take care out there.
Manchaz 860. Doc, cut it out.